What's the gold letter for?
What's the gold wire for?
For spring trap.
For spring trap.
Yeah. That might have been for the music box.
The puppet?
The puppet music box. Got on a road trip in a while. It's nice.
Yeah. What? How long has it been?
I don't know. It's been...
Was it the vacation before last?
So, August?
August. No.
We have not left town since August.
So, we... are doing this the smart way. There are a couple of different ways you can do this the smart way. If you're doing Whole30 or Paleo, you can either pack food and take it with you, which is what we're doing, and so we're doing it the smart, cheaper way.
Mm-hmm.
Or the smart, more expensive way is to, you know, look, go online, find out what restaurants are in the area, and, you know, which ones have options that you can eat that won't break your Whole30 or make you sick. And what are we having tonight?
Well, tonight we are having a spicy deal sardine salad with zucchini noodles.
Mm, sounds good.
Yes. It's all packed up in containers. Have a little picnic.
Is there any pickle in that?
Oh, I forgot the pickle.
I can't believe you forgot the pickle.
I wish I hadn't, too. That'd be really good.
So sad.
You want to turn around and get the pickle?
Nah.
It's too. You just want to make me feel guilty for getting the pickle?
What about dried cranberries?
Yes, there are dried cranberries.
Okay. I'll let you off this time.
And homemade mayonnaise.
Well, of course. Can't make a salad without homemade mayonnaise.
Pretty much you can. We base all of our salad dressings off of it. Yeah.
No, can't eat honey mustard in the field. No,
but we can make our own ranch on the whole
thing. Spicy mayo.
And we can make a cheesy
spicy
ranch.
Mayo.
Cheesy ranch. Black pepper ranch.
Yeah. Creamy Caesar.
Spicy mayo. Creamy Caesar.
So we did that the other day.
Shoot, we can even make a Thousand Island type dressing with our
That's
homemade sugar-free ketchup.
That's right, we need sugar-free ketchup too.
Pickles.
Pickles. That's good. I should make some of that for Burger Movie.
Yes. My mouth's watering right now.
Stop talking about things. We're not having that for dinner.
So, I had some ideas for the new series that I'm thinking about doing, which is the Paleo Tips, Tricks, and Hacks. And I won't go too much into it, but I'm going to start out pretty basic, you know, what Paleo is, what it isn't, what you can and cannot eat. The benefits and all that, and then, you know, progress from there, because while I would love to start, you know, with some real fun stuff, you really need the basics, and I know a lot of people out there may not have that. So what Paleo is, what it isn't, what you can and cannot eat, and want to know it, and there's lots of books, there's lots of information, but may not have the time or energy to read all that's out there. And so I want to bring that, you know, in with a lot.
Yeah, we'll read it so you don't have to.
Because I've read lots.
Yeah, you really have.
Yeah. When I get into something, I really get into it.
Yeah. And that's made a nice partnership for us. She loves to I have the time to do the cooking, and I can stand in the kitchen and do the cooking, because I haven't been on my feet all day like Deborah has. So we'll make a good partnership. You know, she's done all the reading, has really solid grounding with it. She develops, you know, 90% of the recipes. Most of the stuff that, you know, if I come up with anything original, it's usually pretty simple. She comes up with fancy stuff. And so, you know, so basically, you know, she tells me what's cooking out to me. It works out.
I'm really looking forward to that. It's like I've had it on my mind for a little while, and trying to figure out how to make it fun, how to make it interesting. And today I got some thinking done, because while I still didn't have any help in my area, at least I didn't have a bunch of managers coming in and going, "Oh, you're doing a terrible job." They don't actually say that, but they might as well, because just the way they talk to you is not really very nice. And
why can't you do the work of three people, even though we're not paying you extra to get people to?
Yeah.
That's stupid.
And on top of that, yesterday I felt like I was just moving so slow because I was in so much pain. And today I have not been in that much pain. Still got a little bit of pain. And that's one thing that I have found about paleo, is when you're eating this way and you don't have all of that inflammation, then when something does happen, your body can actually heal it and fix it in less time. Like, I burned my finger on vacation because we were hot gluing costume stuff.
Yeah, and you touched the metal tip too, wasn't it?
I put my finger directly in the hot glue right after Liddy touched the metal.
That's right.
I put my finger in the hot glue immediately after putting the hot glue on, because I didn't realize where I was putting my finger at the time. And I mean, it instantly blistered. It was definitely a second degree burn.
Yeah, puffed up.
And I think that was it my last day or the day before my last day of vacation?
I believe it was the day before your last day.
I think so too.
Alex agrees.
And so, you know, it puffed up. I was sitting right in front of the aloe vera, and I didn't even think to put any on. I was in so much pain,
yeah,
I wasn't thinking. And so, you know, I just put some Neosporin on it, put a Band-Aid on it, and tried to keep air away from it. And it was burning. And then the next day, it wasn't burning. And within 5 days, you couldn't even tell that I had burned myself. The skin went right back into place.
I have never seen a burn heal that fast.
I've had burns before, and I've never had them heal that fast before. It was really crazy. And I wish I had documented it. Because,
right.
You know, just saying it out loud.
People are going to be like, yeah.
It sounds crazy. It doesn't sound real. It's like, whatever. Not 5 days. Yeah. And so I showed my friend, because I was like, remember that I burned myself? And she was like, could say things about mutant powers and superheroes, but I'm not going to. And I'm like, no, seriously, it's like eating paleo gives you superpowers. And she eats the standard American diet, and she's like,
I was just like, okay.
But, you know, the proof is that you can't tell. That was less than a month ago. And it was...
Yeah, that was at the beginning of the month.
It was this finger. My middle finger. And it was from here down to here. And from here to the side. And I can tell there's like a little bit of a glossy spot there.
But you know where to look for.
Yeah. And there's a little bit of numbness there where the nerves are still healing. But
yeah, but it is amazing what your body does when it's dealing with chronic inflammation.
I don't know what I did. I don't know why I was in so much pain. But the fact of the matter was, it was like 2 days, and it's over.
Yeah.
I mean, there's still just a little twinge of pain if I move a certain way, but that's it.
And most everything is like that. I mean, things that used to knock you out, like, you know, you're over in a couple of days.
Yeah, I used to at least once, usually 2 or 3 times a year, get bronchitis, and I would be sick. I would have cough for a month.
Yeah, that's no exaggeration either, because she almost died of pneumonia when she was 2, and she's gotten bronchitis every year since.
Well, the reason I got pneumonia is because I had bronchitis, and it turned into pneumonia.
Right. Your mom's the same way, though. She got bronchitis all the time. Jeez.
But I think she might have got it from me. I'm not sure about that.
That's all good.
No. But yeah, bronchitis. At least once a year. I mean, I still get bronchitis. Usually at least once a year. But now, instead of having it for a month, and just, you know, because coughing that much all the time, every day, for more than a couple of weeks will really make you cranky.
Yeah.
Because you don't sleep. And a lot of times when I have bronchitis, the more stressed out I get, the worse I cough.
Yeah.
And when you're coughing like that and you're already stressed out, it doesn't take much to stress you out more to the point where you can't catch your breath, because you're coughing so hard and so much. And so even like people talking to me, I'm like, please don't. I can't. But you know, by that time you can't even be nice about it. You're like, shut up.
Well, it's like you were afraid you weren't gonna be able to graduate from college, because your last semester you literally missed the entire month of February.
Yeah.
Just about every class.
Yeah, and my grades were showing it. I still don't know how I got through that semester with straight A's. So now when I get bronchitis, it's like the really bad part lasts about a week, and then after that, it's just a little annoyance for maybe another week or so, but not like it used to be.
Which is fantastic.
It really is. Because, I'll tell you, I'll tell on you. That's what I'm gonna do. When we went to high school together, I have heard that a lot of people thought I was insurance policy that my job has now would not crack.
Near.
Because my job, they don't even accept doctor's licenses.
I'm still not sure how legal that is.
Fear. I was genuinely sick all the time. And a lot of it had to do with eating the foods that I was eating and not realizing at the time that I was intolerant of a lot of it. And I read something today that was really interesting.
So our book, Primal Body, Primal Mind by Nora T. Get goddess? I don't know.
We're gonna pretend like I said that right.
This chapter is chapter 28. What about food allergies
and sensitivities? And it's talking about how food allergies and sensitivities are a common problem and very complex. It's common among people with learning disabilities, other behavioral disabilities, physiological, emotional, and neurological problems. And I had a lot of physiological problems. So here are some of the symptoms. Hyperactivity. I was a really hyperactive child. Talkative behavior. Inattention, that was not me. Short attention span, not me. Restless legs and finger tapping, that was me. Clumsiness, I was not really clumsy, but the next one, definitely. Insomnia or nightmares. I had a lot of very vivid nightmares when I was a kid and had a hard time sleeping. Nervousness. Irritable, upset, short-tempered. I don't know. I don't remember really having those symptoms before the seizure, but after, when I was on the medication, I kind of developed those. High-strung, excitable, or agitated, not really me. Or depressed a little bit, yeah. Easily moved to tears, easily hurt, definitely. That's definitely me. High sensitivity to odor, light, sound, pain, or cold. I have very high sensitivity to odor. Not so much light, but odor and sound.
Complicates things. I have almost no sense of smell whatsoever.
I mean, I had a hard time with mornings, especially because the smell of food.
But you still didn't really.
Not like I did.
No, not like you did. No, not by any means. But
now that we're eating like this, And then some of the other things are. Nose problems, stuffiness, worry, nose steaming, nose rubbing, aches anywhere, stomach problems. Oh yeah, it's kind of a family trait. In fact, we always called it the back bay stomach. I inherited the back bay stomach.
Was your dad the same way? Victor's just as bad.
Alex too.
Definitely.
Bladder problems.
You get upset tummies really easy.
I am prone to bladder infections. Pale face, dark circles, puffiness. I can show you pictures of when I was just a tiny little kid and I had these huge dark circles under my eyes.
You're the cutest little Wednesday Addams baby.
Little curls, cute, just most excruciating thing I've ever experienced in my entire life. Ear problems? Oh yeah. I used to go to the doctor at least once a year with an ear infection. Excessive perspiration, not so much. Low-grade fever? Yeah, often. Chronic inflammation anywhere in the body. Until we started eating paleo. Yeah. Proneness to allergies.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, so much so that it was like part of my life that I didn't even think of it as having allergies.
Right. And then she starts, when we start living together, that was a big adjustment. I mean, there's detergents we can't use. Dish soap we can't use, either because of the smell or because of the allergens.
And it's like I don't really have allergies, but we can't use that detergent, and we can't use this shampoo or this conditioner because it makes me itchy. I'm allergic to that. It's like, why do you think you don't have allergies?
You're allergic to everything.
Well, I'll have seasonal allergies.
Right. Well, the only allergy you don't have.
And resistance to weight loss, even with exercise and low-calorie diet.
Yeah, so if any of that stuff sounds familiar to you...
You may also have food sensitivity.
Yeah, it's way more common than people think. Like any spouse, anybody who's married or has kids or something, when your significant other or your loved ones are sick, you know how it feels, you know, so you want to help them so much, and, you know, there's really not a lot you can do. So when she has bronchitis, there's nothing I can do. You know, we crank the AC way down, I buy apple juice every time we go to the store, because that's like a few things that could kill the cough in Michigan.
Yeah, because I can't even take most cough medicines.
Yeah, I'm allergic to most cough medicines. Yeah. You don't have allergies.
They either make my heart race, or they...
Yeah. So, you know, I, for one, am so thankful that eating paleo and everything has made it so that's not a, you know, a huge part of our lives anymore.
But I do remember where I was going with that, because I was telling on you.
Yes,
you were telling me. Because when we first got together, he thought, because a lot of other people thought, I was hypochondriac. And so, we get together, we're dating, he tells me this, and I'm like, wow. Because, it's bad to be sick all the time. It's not fun. And then when people don't even believe you, it's just like, thanks guys.
Yeah. It's like, I have never met anyone that got as sick as often and stayed as sick as long as you did.
And then we got married, and we went on our honeymoon. And for some of them, recent, his great parents were very nice, and they got us, they paid for our hotel for our honeymoon, but for some unknown reason, they got us a smoking room. Well, I don't smoke. Ray quit smoking. And
I still remember the smell of that room. That was 6 feet and a half years
old. And it was terrible. So, you know, we tried to spend as little time there as possible, but it wasn't our honeymoon. And okay.
I'm sorry.
want that anymore.
Yeah, I almost froze to death because when I have bronchitis, getting hot, even just a little bit, sets it off, and I start coughing, and I cannot stop coughing. And so I had the air conditioner just crank down, and it was March. So it was
April at that point, because, you know, we got married on the 25th.
Yeah, but it started in March.
Yeah, it started.
The worst part of all of them were.
Yeah.
And so, you know, I had the air conditioner cranked all the way down. Mm-hmm. It's cold outside, it's colder inside. But it's the only way that I can keep her coughing. And he's walking around in his pajamas.
Yeah.
And I've got off shorts.
And I'm wearing jammy pants and a fleece sweatshirt. She's wearing shorts and a t-shirt.
And just try.
Don't sit so close to me on the couch. I'm only getting hot. Yeah, that was our first, month.
Don't snuggle with me.
Don't snuggle with me.
I'm gonna start coughing.
So the no snuggles are our first month of marriage.
Okay.
Yeah. So you told them.
I told them.
Yes.
And they're interrupting you. I'm sorry, but I finally remember where I was going.
No, it's fine. It's great. I'm just relieved that it's not. It's the huge part of our lives that it was. Because, you know, it's like, you know, when you used to get sick, I would really worry about just, like, how long are you going to get sick? Do we, you know, do we have the resources to get you to the doctor when, you know, if you need to, or, you know, buy medication if you need to? Because we get really sick. It was bad.
And see, it's funny because, you know, perspective, I didn't think that I was all that sick.
Right.
Because it wasn't pneumonia or the flu. Although sometimes it started out as the flu.
Yeah, and sometimes it turned into pneumonia.
Well, you know, sometimes.
But that's not something you don't worry about so much now. So you got a hog and bronchitis in your chest. Now you can get some apple juice. Alright. I'll turn the AC down a little bit more to the. And then, you know, in a couple days or a week or something, you know, bronchitis, you know, like you said, a week or two at this point. Just, yeah, I'm all better. Yay.
Anything else?
No, I think,
Got on long enough.
Yeah. So, right. That's been a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Riding the car, talking on.
Telling on you.
Telling on me.
Alright, so.
Anyway.
If you like hearing me tell, right? Then give this video a like.
And if you want to hear her tell more embarrassing stories about me, don't forget to subscribe.
And if you have your own embarrassing stories or people thought you were a hypochondriac, put a comment down below.
Yeah. And if you would like to eat the way we do so that you don't have all these lovely health problems anymore, you know, check out our Patreon and check out the cookbook. And all the details are down in the description.
All of my social media, everything is in the description. And we will see you tomorrow.
That's right. See you later. Bye-bye.
Bye.